This is our 1954 Victoria Bergmeister, one of those beautiful German bikes that were built back in the 50s when there were a lot of German manufacturers before they all fell and only BMW was left. But Victoria had been around for a long, long time, so they'd survived the war and come through it. The problem with these bikes was they were built to too high a standard. They were way too high a quality, and when Germany started producing cars, people all flocked to the cars instead of the motorcycles they had been buying. We're lucky to have this one, which is a 350cc. It's a V-twin, but the V is laid out sideways like a Moto Guzzi. And when I talk about the quality on it, you just got to look at the castings on it, the beautiful chrome bezels. Actually, they're polished aluminum in this case, and all the chrome work on it. And there's a lot of factors in this bike that really make it stand out from other bikes. I particularly like the color too. It's kind of a steel blue-gray, and they've echoed the color into the wheel rims too. So that plays nice with it. It's also very unusual in some of the technologies on it. The transmission on this is most unusual in that it's positioned behind the clutch, but instead of having a series of gears like we know transmissions to be, it was a series of sliding sprockets with chains on them. So the dogs would engage on the faces of them, but they were sprockets, the chain driving another sprocket. You would just pick the ratio as you made your shift on it. So that's most unusual on it. And then it's a drive shaft to the rear wheel. It's got nicely balanced fender at the back to keep the rain from spilling all over the place, and just a general all-around beautiful motorcycle. These were a very efficient engine with the two cylinders sticking out the side like that. They got lots of air cooling being like that. And of course, each one had its own exhaust pipe, and it's fed by a common carburetor in the center. It's an over-square design, and it put out about 21 horsepower, so it was quite lively. It put you down the road about 80 miles an hour. Got two really nice toolboxes, one on either side, and the Kickstarter, in fact, is on the left side. It has its vestigial shifter on it, too, left over from the days when they would have been hand shifters, but this one's a foot shift.
Victoria was a bicycle manufacturer in Nuremberg, Germany, that made motorcycles from about 1901 to 1966. In the early decades, Victoria bought engines from various manufacturers such as FN, Minerva, and Zedel. In 1920, Victoria launched the model KR1, which used a twin-cylinder 494cc BMW motor, which produced 6.5 horsepower and was mounted longitudinally in the frame. It came with a two-speed gearbox. When BMW started manufacturing its own motorcycle, Victoria turned to making its own engines. In 1925, Victoria built Germany's first supercharged engine, and in 1926, a 496cc Victoria achieved a land speed record of 102.5 miles per hour, ridden by Adolf Brutus. From 1930 on, it imported 500cc side valve and overhead valve engines from the English company Sturmey Archer for the KR50 model. In 1932, Victoria won the sidecar class of the European Hill Climb Championship with a 600cc machine. This became the KR6 Bergmeister. It was equipped with a 20 horsepower engine and a 4-speed gearbox. In 1934, the National Socialist government forbade the import of foreign components. This ended Victoria's use of Sturmey Archer engines. In 1935, Victoria revised the KR8 engine. The new KR9 featured an unusual exhaust over inlet valve design. This solved the overheating problem but increased complexity and the cost of manufacturing. In 1939, World War II almost completely halted production of the KR35 Pioneer, although production continued until at least 1942. By the end of World War II, the Victoria factory's production hall was severely damaged. In 1946, Victoria resumed production with a 38cc FM38 bicycle engine. Production of the pre-war KR25 resumed in 1949. In 1950, the KR25 Aero was equipped with a plunger-style rear suspension and sold approximately 14,000 units. In 1953, the V35 Bergmeister was added to the line. This 350cc four-stroke V-twin produced 21 horsepower. Victoria merged with DKW and Expresswork AG in 1958. In 1966, Hercules took over the company and terminated Victoria production.